Yeah, so good morning everyone. So as discussed yesterday, I have shared this, you know, Loadrunner software trial version to you through email, right? To everyone like who don't have an official email ID. And you know, once you start installation, once you download, the file size will be around 1.2 GB or something, right? So let me bring that up. Yeah, so you know, the latest, let me show you something before, you know, before going to installation part. Let me show you something. If you did not install, please wait. We'll do it now. Okay, so you have to check this, you know, Loadrunner 2021 system requirements. Okay, if you Google like this, you know, you will get to know what are the system requirements for this version, for any version for that matter. Okay, when you're installing any software, right, you know, you'll see, you know, there will be some documentation on the system requirements. Right, you see this, right? System requirements means what is the hardware required, what is the software required, and so on. Okay. Now let's go through this, like before starting and going into installation. So Loadrunner Professional and Loadrunner Enterprise post system requirements on Windows operating system. Right, these are the requirements, guys. Hardware, first of all, hardware requirements. What are the hardware requirements? 2-core CPU, 8-core CPU is actually recommended, but 2-core CPU is also supported. That's what it means. You understood, right? You see, supported and recommended, isn't it?
Yes.
The processor, you know, supported is 2-core CPU is also supported. 8-core CPU is recommended, right? I already covered all these computer basics to you, right? How to check your, you know, CPU and all, right? You would simply go to Task Manager, and, you know, go to Performance tab. Go to Performance tab and select CPU, and you will see here how many cores your CPU has. You see here, right? 4, 6 logical processors, 12, right? So this is what they are referring to, guys. You got it there, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and you know, the next requirement is, you know, RAM, memory RAM, right? So you can ignore this UI level protocols. You can ignore this. I'll explain what is this later on, okay? UI level protocols means there are some protocols like Kubernetes protocol in Loadrunner. They require 8-core CPU. That's what it means. 2-core CPU will not be sufficient. And 16-core CPU is recommended. Okay. And coming to RAM, right, you know, 8 GB RAM is, you know, 8 GB RAM is supported. However, you know, 16 GB RAM is recommended. Right. And available hard disk space. So, okay. Memory RAM, memory or RAM for UI level protocols. 16 GB is supported, and you know, 32 GB is recommended to have. Available hard disk space is 50 GB. You should have at least, you know, 50 GB of free space in your C drive. Okay. If you don't have, you know, at least 50 GB in C drive, you know, please move the documents or something which you have on the desktop. Okay. If you have any documents or movie files or, you know, videos on your C drive, desktop, right? Desktop or C drive. So if you have something in desktop, they will be there in automatically. They will be on C drive only, guys. Isn't it? Desktop, if you have something on the desktop, right? Any documents or anything on the desktop, they will be in C drive only. Hope everyone knows that.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So if you don't have, you know, at least 50 GB of hard disk space in C drive, because, you know, by default, it will be installed in C drive, isn't it? Any software will be installed in C drive by default, right? So if you don't have 50 GB of free space in C drive, you know, make it free, like, you know, move some, you know, documents or, you know, and now one more thing, downloads folder also will be there in C drive only by default, right? This downloads folder also will be there by default in C drive only. I moved it to some other drive. Actually, I changed it to some other drive. You see here, right? It is on my machine, it is pointing to G drive, downloads folder. Okay. So but it will be by default C drive only. Is everyone able to follow?
Yes, sir.
Downloads folder will be in C drive only by default. So if you want to change it, you can change it here. Okay, right click and go to properties, and you know, you can change it somewhere here. I think customize. No. Location. Yeah, there is some location thing, right? Yeah. So here you can change it. You can change the downloads folder to some other drive. Got it? This is how I changed it. Right? So if you, suppose if you don't want to move it, right, you know, if you have bulk files in C drive, move it to some other drive. If you want space only, if you have enough space, that's fine. You need not do anything. Is it clear, guys?
Yes, sir.
And next, coming to the software requirements for this version, right? So you got it, right? What we are discussing, everyone, this is system requirements document for version 2021, LoadRunner version, professional version 2021, right? This is, you know, this was released by Micro Focus itself, right? Now, so let's go to the software requirements. What are the software requirements for this LoadRunner professional 2021 version? What are the software requirements, guys? Operating system should be, you know, 8.1 or more, right? So 8.1 64-bit or Windows 10 64-bit versions, or, you know, Windows Server 2012, Windows Server 20, sorry, 2016, 2019. These are server operating systems, guys. These three are server operating systems, okay? Not our, you know, home version, home editions. These are server operating systems, okay? So it will be completely different, guys, okay? So, you know, but more, I believe most of you have Windows 10. So let's ignore that, isn't it? Most of you have Windows 10, right? And, you know, like if you have Windows 8 also, that is fine. But Windows 7 and lower versions are not supported by this version 2021. Is it clear, guys?
Yes, sir.
And the browser, coming to browser, of course, if you have Windows 10 or Windows 8, you will have IE11 by default, okay? And browser version recommended is IE11, Internet Explorer 11, or Microsoft Edge, right? And the screen resolution should be 1366x768 or higher. Okay, this is supported. The recommended is 1600x900 or higher. And how to see the screen resolution? You go to desktop, right click, and, you know, go to display settings, right? You see the screen resolution somewhere here. You see here, right? Display resolution 1920x1080. That is the one on my machine. Okay, I changed it to, you know, actually to 1920x1080. This is how you can check the screen resolution. But my maximum screen resolution is 3840x2160. Okay, so ignore that, you know, why, what is that, you know, and all, just ignore it. But this is how you can check your screen resolution. This is the current screen resolution for me on my machine, right? So what is that? How much is that? 1920x1080. And, you know, this is what they are mentioning here, guys. 1600x900 or higher is recommended. Okay, so I have higher screen resolution, that's fine. You got it? Is it clear, guys?
Yes, sir.
Any background noise from my side? So whenever you are, installing any software, right, you have to check what are the system requirements. Otherwise, you know, it may not work properly, isn't it? And, you know, before you install any components on a Windows machine, make sure that the full set of Windows updates has been installed, or install the Windows updates listed in the table below. So before trying to install LoadRunner software, right, you know, you have to check, you know, you have to do the Windows updates. That's what this means, right? So how to check, you know, if your Windows updates are installed? Go to your Windows search window, search prompt, or search window, Windows search window, right? And, you know, check this, you know, Windows, type Windows updates. Okay, so you can use this check for updates or Windows update settings, anything is fine, right? Go to check for updates. You will end up on this Windows updates, right? So, you know, if you have any updates, right, you know, please update your Windows operating system first. You got it? Guys, able to understand?
Yes, 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 sir.
Do this first. Before starting LoadRunner installation, do this first. Okay? So, if you already did installation, that's fine. Not an issue. If you face some issue, we'll see. Okay? Don't worry about that. if you already installed it. Okay, but if you are trying now, first do this Windows updates. Can you do that first, everyone? Please. Because, you know, some people turn off the Windows updates, you know, and it will take some time, actually, if you want to install. If you want to install LoadRunner, right, you know, if you want to install a Windows updates, it will take some time. Okay, so these are about the system requirements on Windows operating system, guys. The next pages, you know, you have for Linux, what are the system requirements for Linux, right? So I hope no one is using Linux, so I'll go ahead with this, right? So did you start Windows updates, guys?
Yes, sir, it's done.
Yes, sir.
And observe here, you know, this is called as, also called as product availability matrix document, PAM document, PAM, product availability matrix. Can one of you share your screen? Those who are installing, you know, those who did not install, can one of you share your screen, please? When you are installing, can you take screenshots and save it in a Word document, please, for me? Because I already have 2021 on my machine. Okay. I have already installed 2021. So one of you, you know, can share your screen and, you know, take screenshots and paste it in a Word document. Yeah, I will. So Windows updates are going on. I will pause recording. Once the updates are done, I will, you know, resume recording. Yeah. So one, yeah, hold on. So once you are on this window, right, you know, read it. What is it saying? What does it say? The following prerequisite programs must all be installed before you can install LoadRunner. Right, that's what it is saying. The following prerequisite programs must be installed before you can install Micro Focus LoadRunner. Right, and you know, it is saying that installing network virtualization requires disabling the Windows Smart Screen, verifying that all the required Microsoft Windows updates are installed. You see this one, right? You see this statement, right? That is the reason I asked you, you know, to do the Windows update. Let me highlight this, guys. Okay, so see here. It will verify if all the required, you know, Microsoft Windows updates are installed. Okay. If it did not do, this will verify. You got it, guys? Everyone? So just click OK here. Okay. So click OK. Read, understand it. When you get some window, right? Understand it. Click OK to begin installing these programs now. Right? So now what? Now click OK.
So screenshot. Can I take a
screenshot? Take a screenshot. Paste it in Word document. And you know, then you can proceed. Alt print screen, take alt print screen, go to Word document, paste it. Yes. So LoadRunner software installation is very, very much easy. Okay, you just, you know, click on next, that's it. Okay, only at one step you need to do some, you have to uncheck a checkbox, that's it. Other than that, you know, it's all next. Hey, what happened? Setup wizard ended prematurely. Why? Ended prematurely because of an error. Okay, click the finish button. Okay, start it one more time from the beginning. Is someone at this step, guys? Hold on. I'll come back to you. So is someone, you know, doing installation, guys? Guys, please respond.
I'm doing.
Yeah, can you please share your screen? Sai Manohar, I will come back
to you. I'm also doing,
sir. Yeah, okay, sir.
It's almost done.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, someone else who is doing installation, can you please share your screen? Yeah. Hey, Simon, we'll do it offline, okay?
Okay, sir.
Did you click cancel anytime by mistake, Simon Ahern?
No, sir. No, sir. I didn't do that.
Okay, that's fine. We will see what is the issue.
Okay, sir.
So right now we know it is installing. You can see here installing Micro Focus VUGen, right? Please wait while the setup wizard installs VUGen 2021, and you can see the progress bar, isn't it?
The Windows updated.
What is that?
Windows update installing status instant 21% chupistundi.
Okay. Let it complete in that case.
Okay.
If you are doing Windows updates, right, you know, please complete that. If it is progressing, please complete that. And then start this installation.
Okay.
Right? So we will share the, you know, I shared the, you know, screenshots, right? A document with the screenshots. Or else, you know, if you take it now, you are taking screenshots, Bhagwati?
Yes, Anaya.
Yeah. So Bhagwati will share you this document to you. So you can simply follow this code document. Okay.
Okay.
I will pass recording because it is taking. It is done with writing the registry. Okay. Can you go to the installation window? Yeah. Publishing product features and updating component registration. Now it is registering the components. Okay. Total there are 209 components. So, you know, you can see the progress, which component is getting registered. Of course, you know, we are not bothered about this, but I'm just explaining. Still taking some time, right? Applying configuration. Yeah. You can go ahead with any browser. So network, what? So this is actually readme file. You know, you can bookmark this one, Bhagwati. Okay. Bookmark this. So basically what it, you know, I'll explain what is this readme file. Okay. View load runner, you know, 2021 readme file. Okay, yeah, can you go to that, you know, that installation window once? So it is installing network virtualization. Maybe may know from this 2021 version, maybe they made it mandatory. I'm not sure. That's fine, let it proceed. Okay. So let it proceed, you know, yeah. So go to that readme file. We will discuss that readme. What is that readme file meanwhile? Let us understand, you know. Yeah. So this is readme file for, you know, any software will have a readme file. Okay. Any software, when you install, right, any software, it will have some readme file. So what is it saying? See here, that the readme provides information to get you started. Let me highlight it. Okay. So see. So the readme provides information to you to get you started with LoadRunner Professional and Virtual User Generator 2021, right? So this is the document on this particular software. What is new? The first point that we see is what is new. What is new means over previous version, what are the new features introduced in this version? What are the new features introduced in this version? That is this thing. And system and protocol requirements means what are the system requirements for running this software, and LoadRunner Professional installation guide and VUGen installation guide. You can click on those links to go to that, you know, go to the corresponding one. Let me clear these annotations. Yeah, click on any link. Yes, right. It is showing you system requirements document, isn't it, which I have shown you before. Now click on that, you know, support matrix 2021 R1 support matrix or something. It will open the PDF. You got it, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Right? And go to the readme file one more time, please. Yes. So can you give me control once?
Yeah.
I'm sending a request. Please, I've just approved it, please.
Okay.
No, I am unable to scroll down. Can you please scroll down? Yeah, scroll down. Yes. Okay. See our online help centers for, you know, Vue and TruePlant and developer and develop, right? So you understood, right? Basically, any software will have this README file. They're explaining about there, you know, what are the new features in this version and so on. What are the system requirements? What are the, you know, new features introduced and so on, right? So this is about README. Yeah, you can close this and go to the installation window.
Okay.
And Subhashni, you told that, you know, you got one window, right? Can you please share your screen once?
Yes, sir.
You are stuck at some window, right? Can you please share your screen?
This is the one I'm getting, sir.
No, your screen is still loading. Yeah.
Okay.
Now, you know, if you get this window, right? Yeah. Uncheck that, you know, the first checkbox. Specify a certificate, you know. No, first checkbox. Checkbox.
Okay.
So those are radio buttons. Wait.
Yes. This one, sir.
Let me annotate.
Okay.
Yes. This one. Unselect that.
I'm not able to select, sir.
You are not able to unselect?
Yes.
No, it will not be the case. Okay. You change the radio button. Yeah. Click the second radio button. By default,
yes.
It will be there. Yeah. Yes, now you can uncheck now. Still you are unable?
No, sir. Even though.
How come is that?
Before she clicked the CA certificate file, sir, that is why it was struck, I think so.
No, that is her cursor actually. That round one is her cursor. I think it is not, it's not processing. It's not a processing symbol. Click next once. Click the next button once. It will not proceed anyways. Okay. Now uncheck it. Uncheck that checkbox.
No, sir. It was.
No. Uncheck and wait for some time.
Okay.
It's asking for me to restart. Can I restart?
Yeah. You can restart, Bhagat. Did anyone, you know, land up on this window?
No, sir.
Yes,
it has moved before and after unchecked.
What is that?
After uncheck that box, no, it was moved to next.
Yeah. Once you uncheck this and, you know, click next, it will be completed.
Yeah.
Actually.
Yes.
So, but, you know, somehow back and cancel buttons both are disabled. Messed up something. Something was messed up here.
Sir.
Yes.
Yeah, so that's how it is, like, you know, once you are in this window, right, you have to uncheck this and you can, you know, click next and proceed. Not sure, you know, what went wrong here. Okay, hold on. Let me check the, you know, let me check the screenshot document. Resume recording. Once you install Loadrunner, if it is successful, right, you know, you'll get these three components. Okay, let me highlight those. These are the three components that will be installed. Hold on. These are the three components that should be installed. Virtual user generator, controller, and analysis components. Right? You see, you got it, right? So
yes.
This component is for, you know, this is for, you know, like for the script recording or creating a script. See this one. This is for, you know, this is for generating the scripts. That's why it is called as virtual user generator. And the next component, this one is for executing the tests. Okay. Controller is for doing the load test performance test. Analysis is component is for analyzing the results.
Okay.
This analysis component, this is for analyzing the test results. Okay. So basically, then it is successful. Then your installation is successful. Now, can you launch the VueGen, Anusha? Virtual user generator, that is also, that is in short called as VueGen. Just double click it to launch it. Screen is very colorful. Yes, please wait. Click on allow access here. Yeah. If you get this window, right, you know, this is one time, you know, the first time you launch VUGEN, you'll get that. Click allow access. Yes. So this is how your VUGEN looks like. Okay. Now let me share my screen. So installation is successful on your machine. This, installation is went perfectly fine and it is successful. Okay.
Yes.
Now let me share my screen. I'm stopping your screen share and I'm sharing my screen. All right. So, I am launching VUGEN on my machine. Here it is, right? Can everyone, those who installed successfully, can everyone launch this VUGEN on your machine? But observe here, this is version 2021. This is called as splash screen. This is called as splash screen. On that, it shows you the version, load runner version, right? Now, let us understand this UI first, okay? So you have, this is called as menu bar. Let me annotate this. See, this is called as menu bar. This is called as menu bar. In the browser also, hold on. Go to mouse. See, in the browser also, let me clear this. In the browser also, if you open any browser, say, for example, let me open, Edge browser or, Internet Explorer. I think, that is better. You will understand, everyone will understand. Just to make everyone understand, I am opening Internet Explorer. Right? So, this is called as menu bar, isn't it? So, this is called as menu bar, this one. Got it? Menu bar. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So here, by default, you will not have the menu bar. You have to do some, setting to see that. Okay, fine. Let's leave it. Let's go back to VUGEN. So this is your menu bar, right? And here you are seeing some scripts, right? It will show you the last 10 scripts here. Okay. This recent activity, right? It will show you the last 10 scripts that you opened. For now, it will be empty for you because you did not do any script till now. That's why it will be empty for you, isn't it? Guys, yes or no?
Yeah.
Right? For you, it is not showing any, it will not show you any recent activity. Can you share your screen, one of you? Just for recording purpose. I'm stopping my screen share.
Excuse me, sir.
Sorry.
So I got finish, then I clicked on the finish. Mm-hmm. Now it is asking mm-hmm. open a read file or open installation log, which one I have.
Yeah, that's fine. You can ignore, you can click OK. By default, open readme file will be selected. You can click OK.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So now see here, once you click OK, right, it will open readme file. Just bookmark that readme file.
Okay, sir.
So you see my VUGEN, right? You see Anusha's VUGEN, right? There is no recent activity because we haven't done any script yet. You got it right?
Yes.
See,
after
here, this area will contain a list of recently opened items. Means it will show you the recently opened scripts. Okay. Now, so what is new? A new update is available, Loadrunner Professional 2021 R1. So, they have released a new version, leave it. Okay, you can ignore that. And what is new in, it is showing what is new in 2021 R1 release, right? So now, let me clear this all drawings. Okay, let me show you how to create a script. So how to create, record a script. For example, we are going to, what is the time now? Guess what is the time now?
8:40.
Yeah. So can you start, did you install WebTools also, Anusha? Do you have WebTools application on your machine?
Yes, sir.
I will go ahead with WebTools only because it is a very simple application to understand, you know. So as we have freshers also in our batch, you know, I'll go with a simple, very simple application. Can you start WebTools server also? So you are starting a sample application, a sample travel application, right? WebTools is our, I covered your WebTools for you, right? For your batch, in your batch. I gave, you know, I explained like, you know, what is that WebTools application and all to everyone, right? No, no, it's already started. It started. No, if you want to switch back to VueGen, use Alt tab. Use Alt tab on your keyboard. I'm not seeing your, you know, taskbar. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Okay, guys. So, you know, let's stop here. We will continue tomorrow. And, you know, first let us sort out all the installation issues for everyone. Okay. Then we will see the script recording. Okay. I'm pausing the recording. Okay. So, you know, we'll continue tomorrow. So let's sort out all the installation issues. Then we will, you know, do our, you know, we'll proceed to our scripting, you know, in the next session. Okay. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, subscribe to my YouTube channel.